The word epigenetics was defined historically as describing a case where someone inherits a trait from their mother or father unrelated to a change in DNA sequence. However, more recently, a broader definition is used of epigenetics, where it is describing any stable change in the structure of a gene that doesn't involve a change in DNA sequence, whether that change is inherited, is heritable or not. The latter type of epigenetics has helped us enormously in identifying genes in the brain that are regulated in animal models of depression, and has helped us identify the biological basis of depression and antidepressant treatment. The historic definition of epigenetics is in some ways more interesting but also more difficult, and the question is, does a person's life experience actually cause stable changes in the genes in their germ cells, meaning egg or sperm cells, that are somehow transmitting that behavioral experience onto their children? That is quite a provocative idea, and there is some early evidence that it might actually occur, in which case the consequences of suffering severe horrendous stress would be far-reaching and would help us perhaps identify some of the mechanisms of vulnerability of offspring of those individuals. Yeah, it's really a very provocative but very exciting.